All right, let's check travel conditions now. Jen has all the details.
All right, for travelers heading out by air today, let's check in with the FAA. Ricky Bell is on the phone this morning. Ricky, good morning. I think we're going to give New York City a break, but Chicago is getting a hard time because of the weather, windy there, and they happen to open up a new runway. Will that help or hurt things today?
Good morning, Jen. First question. Yes, it will be windy. We can expect a ground stop into Chicago this morning at 8 o'clock, and that should last an hour for flights within a 300-mile radius of Chicago. As far as the new runway goes, it will help once everyone is comfortable with the new procedures. New procedures brings that new runway, and that will slow arrivals down and departures as we get used to working with it.
We've had a lot of ups and downs in our weather around Denver recently. Today's a down. We have cool temperatures, below freezing, actually. Freezing drizzle could be a problem. Would that cause delays in Denver?
Yes, that could cause delays as we go into a de-icing mode at Denver. We expect departures to be within a 30-minute departure delay. Arrivals should be normal, but we could see a 30-minute arrival delay as we reroute airplanes into Denver because of the low ceilings and the weather.
And Ricky, for West Coast travelers, what do you think about the fog in San Francisco this morning?
We will have a ground delay program out for San Francisco within 2 hours, and that program will have 35 to 45-minute arrival delays into San Francisco.
All right, typical morning here. Thanks for the update. We look forward to talking with you again tomorrow, Ricky. Right now, for anyone traveling, heading out, we're going to show you what's happening for the morning commute.